We're learning more about what happened the night Mollie Tibbetts was slain, allegedly by an illegal alien. This is the cornfield in Iowa where her body was believed to have been found. You can see an ominous gap in the 8-foot-high corn.
This was the country road where Mollie was jogging when police say the suspect, Christian Rivera, got out of his car and started running alongside Mollie. Mollie got scared and pulled out her phone and threatened to call police. Now, what happened next remains unclear, but somehow Mollie ended up inside the suspect's vehicle.
Investigators say he then drove to a spot on this lonely road where he dumped Mollie's body and covered it with corn stalks. Meanwhile, President Trump stood on the front lawn of the White House and denounced the slaying of the 20-year-old college student.
Mollie Tibbetts, an incredible young woman, is now permanently separated from her family.
Trump posted the video to Twitter, another sign he's making Mollie's murder, allegedly at the hands of a farm worker originally from Mexico, a key issue in the midterm elections that could make or break his administration.
We need the wall. We need our immigration laws changed.
And look at this, a poster of Mollie on the floor of the U.S. Senate, put there by Iowa's Chuck Grassley.
It seems this murder was preventable.
But a distant relative of Mollie said her murder was being used for political propaganda, calling it despicable and disrespectful. And Mollie's aunt went on Facebook to remind everyone that evil comes in every color. The owner of the dairy farm where Rivera worked now says the suspect used a fake name when he applied for the job.
Our employee was not who he said he was.
He says his family has been bombarded with more than 100 threatening voicemails after it was revealed they employed Rivera.
There were death threats, people threatening to burn down our buildings, somebody threatened to kill my dog.
In Mollie's hometown of Brooklyn, Iowa, a prayer service was held for her last night. Life has changed for many in the small town.
People are afraid. This doesn't happen to small town Iowa.
It's sad that you kind of lose that innocence.
The owner of the local True Value Hardware says he's been making more keys for worried residents.
Most people probably didn't lock their door.
Well, they're locking their doors now.